Hi! In this video, we're going to look at Java unit tests using JUnit. Now, testing is extremely important, even more so when we start automating our build process. Java unit tests are classes which test our application classes. This is the fifth video in a larger playlist for creating microservices in Java. You can find the link for the full playlist in the text below. Now, when we build our code, our plan is to deploy it as quickly as possible. Of course, we don't want to deploy broken code, so we need a reasonable assurance that the code that we're deploying works. That's where Java unit tests come in. Java unit tests are tests that we write in Java to test our application and are run after we compile our code. We're using JUnit and Apache Maven to handle our Java unit tests. Specifically, we're going to use JUnit 4. They've changed much about how they write JUnit tests between 3 and 4, so we need to make sure that we're using JUnit 4. When we create our Java application using a Maven archetype, it adds JUnit 3 by default. The first thing we want to do is change the Maven coordinates in our POM file to make sure that we're using JUnit 4. There should already be coordinates added, so all we need to do is change the version to the current version. That's 4.12 as of when this video is filmed. When we build our application, Maven runs through several phases in its lifecycle. The important ones we're paying attention to are compile, test, package, install, and deploy. When we ask Maven to deploy our application, it first runs through other phases. If any phases fail, our build process stops. So if we test our code and our tests fail, our code will never get past the test phase. That's exactly what we want. This will ensure our microservice isn't deployed until all of our tests pass. There are two ways to add unit tests to existing classes. One is to use the NetBeans IDE. If we right-click on a class, then select Tools, Create, Update Tests, that will create a unit test for the selected class after we select the features we want in our unit test. This is often a quick way to generate tests for our classes. The other way is to create the class manually. If we look in the source directory for our project, we'll see a main directory and a test directory. The test directory is where the unit tests go. The package structure should match our source package structure. So, if our class is in COM DGU Trivia model, that package structure should be matched in the test directory. Usually, we name the class the same as the class we're testing, but we suffix it with the name with the word test. So the Trivia App class will have a test class called Trivia App Test. That's just a convention, we could name it anything. If we look at a test class, we'll see the absolute minimum required for a unit test in Java. We import the necessary JUnit classes, and we have a test method. Every test method has the annotation @test above the test method. Each method should test one thing. Every test method often has some call to assert. Assert says, this thing is true, and if it isn't, the test fails. Usually, we match at least one method for every public method in a class to test. That's really the bare minimum. Every time we add a new feature or fix a defect, we should add at least one unit test for the change. Let's start with Trivia Question Array Access class. We'll create a class called Trivia Question Array Access Test. We'll start by testing each method. The pattern is, usually we make the call and we build an object that matches what we expect. If the two are equal, we pass the test. In this test, we get a list of questions. We check to make sure the list isn't null, and then we check to make sure the size is 10. If those conditions are met, we assume the test passed. We could also add tests to make sure that there's no duplicates or any other case that we want to ensure. A good practice is to add a test for every bug found in the system. So when you find a bug, add a unit test to check for that bug and then fix the bug. This way, old bugs are never reintroduced. The tests for Trivia Question Builder are a little more interesting. We want to make sure our builder can't build objects in an inconsistent state. What should happen in our builder is, if we can't create the object, we should throw an illegal argument exception. If we try to build a bad Trivia Builder, an illegal argument exception means the test was successful. In our @test annotation, we specify the exception we expect. If you want to review the complete test source code, make sure you check out the source on GitHub. To test if our unit tests work, we run Maven test. This will compile the code and then run our unit tests. We should see the results from our tests and hopefully they're successful. Let's go back and change a test to intentionally fail. We'll change the number of questions in our test to 100. In this case, the test will fail and Maven will report the build failed. That looks like this. Maven will even tell us which tests fail and why it fails. Looks like everything is working as we expect. And that's how unit tests work in JUnit. These tests will help us ensure our code is functioning as intended before we push it to production. JUnit 5 is in beta and should be launched by the end of 2016. I'll create an update to the JUnit tutorial sometime in 2017. But this code should work for version 4 and 5. Thanks for watching the video. You can find the source code and a complete transcript on deegu.com. Next, we'll take a look at storing our trivia microservice code in Git. If you like what you're seeing or if you have any questions, let me know in the comments or on deegu.com. And I'll see you in the next tutorial.